While some are complaining of the recent downpour, we would like to celebrate the rain. Live from Beverly Hills is Ariana Grande with more to report.
Thanks, Gaga. Rain on me, soon on me.
I saw a tiger, now I understand. I saw...
Today is June 1st, marking the official start of Pride Month, not only here in the state of New Jersey, but across the entire globe.
Aaron, it's June, it's Pride Month. We have to get ready. It's Pride Month.
One eternity later.
Gotta quit this crying.
Let's do this.
Nobody's gonna kill me if I don't know.
Hey Laura, I'm down here. Where is everybody?
Wait, what? You're where? No. Yeah, I totally get it. How are we going into the first weekend in June and not congregating in Asbury Park? I feel it. Well, this year, because of the pandemic and the restrictions on large gatherings, and you know Jersey Pride's event is a spectacularly large gathering, we've had to make some changes. We've postponed our in-person Pride celebration until October 11th, to coincide with National Coming Out Day. Remember? Well, mark your calendar. And for Pride Month, we've gone virtual. 2 hours of fabulous performers, speakers, and special attractions. We've heard from so many people who come to Pride and say that Pride isn't just about a single day or a single event. It's about what's in our hearts. It's about the community that we build. Can you help us get the word out about United in Pride?
Oh, I know just who to call. Hey, Governor Murphy? I'm calling to tell you that Pride is going to be virtual this year.
Christian, is that you?
Oh, Governor McGreevy.
Of course I know that this year, Pride is virtual. Happy and healthy Pride Day from a proud gay American.
Yes, I know that you are. Happy Pride. Hi, Governor Murphy? Hey, I'm calling to tell you that Pride is going to be virtual this year.
Hey, thanks for letting me know, pal. Count me in, as always.
Hello, and welcome to Gay Pride. Gay Pride Jersey. My favorite Gay Pride, because I sort of like to think of myself as a Jersey girl. It's kind of a lie, because I'm from Lancaster County, Pennsylvania. But for 10 years, I lived in New Jersey, up in Ridgefield Park. So that's almost right. And I did have really high hair for a long time, too, so that kind of makes me Jersey-ish, although they don't really do that anymore, and I'm ready for it to come back. Bring back the spiral perm, please! Oh, God, that was so good. So, times are crazy. This is how we're doing Gay Pride this year. I think most of you, if anybody's over 35 or 40, you know that the original Gay Pride started as riots. It wasn't a parade. It was 3 days of people going out and looting and being crazy. Most of the looting was always, it's always by other people they come along. But that's how it always starts. Change starts with a bunch of people who care, getting in the streets and saying, you need to care too. So that's who we are. And so I think change is gonna be good and we're gonna do this. It's been a little crazy. I gotta be honest, I can't do another jigsaw puzzle. I was not good at them ever. And then my girlfriend comes in because she's working in the office. The office is in the house. And she goes, click, 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 click. And I'm like, I just spent like an hour just turning them over to be the right size. So, and social distancing, seriously, I'm an extrovert. I walk up, I hug people I don't know. I like hugging and touching. This is made for those creepy people that you went to school with that don't want to touch anybody. And I'm saying social distancing is the birth control we didn't know we needed. I guess it's not really birth control for as many gay people, but I think you know what I'm trying to say. So, and I think it's also gonna be easier, I've said this, social distancing is gonna be easier for the drag queens, okay? Because they got those big boobs right out there, they're already giving you 3 feet before you even walk up, so it's gonna make it easier. Anyway, it's Jersey Pride, that's the best pride. Next year, I'm gonna be there, I hope you will be too. We're gonna be outside, we're gonna be nuts, Asbury Park, you know, that's who we are. This year, we're doing it like this. We're gays, we know how to do this kind of stuff. We are literally the best at protesting. We've been practicing it for like at least my 40 years of doing it, okay? So get out there, change the world. Remember, you're from Jersey. And everybody looks to Jersey. So happy Gay Pride. Happy Jersey Pride inside the house. but just this one time. Have a great time.
Hi, my name is Sherry Race, and I'm the Special Events Director for Jersey Pride. I've been a member of Jersey Pride almost from the very beginning, and from the very first day I volunteered, I haven't stopped once, and that's 20 years, a long time. I'm wearing a vintage Pride t-shirt today from 2003, All Roads to Justice, and that is every bit as important now as it was back then. When we look around us, the world is not the same, and we are really one family, and that's how we need to behave. So welcome to our virtual Pride celebration. I've been there when it's cold and rainy and, all right, liquid sunshine, and I've been there when it's bright and shiny. And wherever you are, that's where Pride is. And wherever we are together, that's where we shine. Thank you for joining us for the 2020 virtual Pride for Jersey Pride. And remember to join us October 11th in Asbury Park. Thank you very much for coming out, and stay well, stay healthy, wear a mask.
Hi, I'm Allie from Betty. Betty had such an amazing time last year at Jersey Pride in Bradley Park. I'm really heartbroken that we can't celebrate with you again this year in person. But just know, all three members of Betty send our love and our best wishes and say to each and every one of you, Happy Pride! Pride is inside, and we can always celebrate it, no matter where we are or who we're with. Although, it helps if you're in a huge party. Anyways, we all need to rise together. We need to rise up against hatred and bigotry in all of its forms. We need to vote like our lives depend on it and get everyone we know to vote as well. Hopefully, we'll all meet again soon on the other side of this strange and bewildering time. We can all be partying by the beach there in gorgeous Asbury Park and know that we have done everything we need to make it a better world. Because Betty knows when we unite for fairness and equality, gangway.
Stride through the square,
stride through the square,
in tri-colored rags, fist in the air,
fist in the air,
hail your flag. Did you now?
Did you?
Did you now?
Did you know?
Rise in the street,
rise in the street,
face in the crowd, march to the beat.
March to the beat.
Did your faith make you proud?
Is it time now
to take cover?
Is it time now
to draw the blinds?
Is it time now
for bread and water?
Too late.
No sweet cakes, no wine.
Gangway.
Gangway. Grab your gang for the revolution. Take a stand. When the people demand gangway. Pauline and Claire drove a king from his lair. Just think that your dreams could rip holes in the air. Did you now?
Did you now?
Did you? Did you now?
Did you now?
Just wait for a sign.
Wait for a sign.
Hate to delay. Pray for a sign.
Pray for a sign.
Like Charlotte Corday.
Is it time now?
Take cover.
Is it time now?
Draw the blinds.
Is it time now?
For bread and water.
Too late.
No sweet cakes, no wine. People demand gangway.
glory, glory, hallelujah. Praise the fact, outrageous rebellion start with everyday acts. On a bridge, on a bus, or under attack, stronger together we will never,
never go back.
Gangway, gangway, grab your gang for the revolution. Take a stand for the revolution when the people demand. Gangway, gangway.
Hi, it's Cory Booker, and I am so honored to, for another year, to help celebrate, kick off, and truly commemorate Jersey Pride Month. Now look, we are not together physically, but spiritually we stand in solidarity to the cause of our country that is still, unfortunately, denied to too many LGBTQ Americans. Whether it is our black trans family that faces so much pain and attack and assault and sadly death, whether it's the fact that our youth, our LGBTQ youth in this country, are more likely to be homeless, or about 30% report missing school because of fear, or whether it's the fact that basic human rights in this nation, basic equality, is being denied to many LGBTQ families who can be fired from their job in the majority of our states just because they're gay with no legal recourse. We have come so far, but we have so far to go. So we must continue to celebrate, to activate. We must continue to ignite our pride and our convictions that we will make this nation one day truly a nation for with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. I love you. I love you, and I look forward to the next time we can celebrate physically in person. All the best.
Pride means a lot to me. I'm really happy that I get to work for a company like Bank of America, where we celebrate people's differences and we can all come through the front door being our true selves. And personally, it means a lot to me because my ex-husband of 26 years and father of my two daughters came out gay, and now he can live with his partner and have a happy life and be his true self.
We are a gentle, angry people, and we are singing, singing for our lives. We are a gentle, angry people, and we are singing, singing for our lives. We are a land of many colors. We are a land of many colors. And we are singing, singing for our lives. We are a land of many colors. And we are singing, singing for our lives. I wrote this song when Harvey Milk and Mayor Moscone were assassinated in San Francisco. And we were angry, and we were hurt, and we were shocked, and we mobilized. And we had people whose anger went out there and started burning cars and breaking windows, and it was understandable. Oh my gosh, it was understandable. But eventually, we pulled it back around together and said, let's build a movement. Let's build a movement that can do substantial long-term change. And we are in a time right now where I am so angry that we haven't done it right yet. We've had centuries of time to get this right, and we haven't done it right yet. So here is an opportunity for us to join together with all the skill that the GLBTQ community has. We've been organizing. We know how to organize. We know how to reach each other. We are diverse. We are multicultural by nature because we fall in love with one another, and we have to get to know each other. But it doesn't mean that we have undone our racism as a community yet. So here is a chance to just jump to it, use all our organizing skills, and make this happen. On behalf of ourselves and on behalf of the world, we can participate in this, and let's get it right this time. Let's get it right. We are all in this together, and we are singing, singing for our lives. We are all in this together, and we are singing, singing for our lives. Hang in there. Be brave, be active, be visible, be desperately in love with one another so that all that we are is held high and protected. I send you lots of love and courage. Remember to vote. Remember to remove this president. Remember not to get caught up in political purities right now. We can't afford anything but to remove him from office, flip the Senate, and try to bring some kind of conscious integrity back into the leadership of this country. I know there's been genocide from the beginning. Democracy does not equal rights for everybody yet. We haven't done that right yet. But here's yet another chance for us to pull everything we know together and take a big leap to get closer to getting it right.
Hi, we're the Luckies, and we're getting ready to head out to Virtual Pride. Happy Pride, everybody!
Happy Pride!
Thank you.
Happy Pride.
Happy Pride.
Go Pride!
Hey, New Jersey, Governor Phil Murphy here to wish you all a very happy Pride Month. Each June, we celebrate the incredible contributions of our LGBTQ plus community. From the military to business, sports, and the arts, there is not one facet of society that has not been made better and richer by the presence and inclusion of members of the LGBTQ plus community. Pride may look different this year and feel bittersweet as some of our beloved friends and allies are newly missing from our lives, but we are grateful for every memory we have of them. I want to take this opportunity to encourage more New Jerseyans to get tested. It is vitally important that we know how COVID-19 has impacted every community. This year, we may not be able to take part in the parades and parties, but the spirit of Pride goes far beyond these traditions. This month stands as an important reminder of how far we have come and how hard we have had to fight to get here. And our LGBTQ plus brothers and sisters are valued members of our New Jersey family. They are our loved ones, our friends, our neighbors. And together we have made great strides in making New Jersey a beacon of inclusion and a model of diversity for our entire nation. So long as I am governor, and I hope for long after, New Jersey will remain a place where everyone is given equal protection under the law. Everyone is a valued member of our family, and everyone is not just welcomed, but celebrated. These are the values that all New Jerseyans share. Let's use today, this Pride Month, and every day in the future to remind us that New Jersey refuses to step backward. We will only move forward, and we will do it together. God bless you all. Happy Pride Month.
Jersey Pride! It's your Jersey girl, Janice Robinson. And you know what? I'm a. I'm a. You wanna sing it with me? I'm a. I'm a dreamer. Put your hands in the air, Jersey Pride. I'm coming. I can't wait to come home and sing for y'all. It's a classic. It's a global classic. Sing with me. Love, life, and laughter is all I believe. My savior is pure now, because my lonely heart would bleed. I never learned how to hold love and stay strong to now. I close my eyes now, and I'm dreaming right where I belong. Oh, oh, oh. Hands in the air, hands in the air. It's a pandemic, but we can still party, y'all. Just let me down, never leave me. I'm a dreamer.
come dream and light where I belong. I belong, you belong, we belong. Yes. Here we lie all alone, never dreaming. Yours, no, my soul is never leaving. Now you're sitting on me, I'm a feeling, I'm a feeling. I feel your hands, your lips, that cheat, everybody. You love me, say love me. Could you slow me down, never leave me. I'm a dreamer. Here we lie all alone in my dreaming. Yours move my soul, it's never leaving. Now you say to me, I'm a feeling, I'm a feeling. I feel your hands, your lips, the heat of your body. Whisper you love me, say love me. Please just slow me down, never leave me. I'm a dreamer. Oh, oh, oh. 25 years later.
And we good.
Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's your boy Lane McCray from the Boosh. And I just want to say happy Pride to everyone out there. This year obviously is a little bit different. We're not able to assemble and raise our hands and shake our booties and all that good stuff, but virtually we're going to try to do that for you guys through song, and so we'll see how that goes. I also wanted to share with you guys an old proverb that my grandmother used to tell me about. It's an old Yoruba proverb, and it said, if we stand tall, it's only because we stand on the backs of those who came before us. So when you look at everyone who's ever stood up for LGBT rights, you know, all the way back to Stonewall, and even prior to that, that we have the luxury of being who we are today because of those people. And we need to continue to stand on the backs of those who seem to want to oppress African Americans disproportionately through unnecessary violence through the police departments. So let's keep everyone in prayer. All lives matter. Black lives matter, Latin lives matter, everyone's lives matter. We get it. But right now, at this particular point in time, we are focusing on black lives because we are dying people. Okay? Anyway, happy Pride.
Hi, everybody. I'm Maria Sammartino, editor-in-chief of Atlanta, Jersey Magazine. Pride to me is about having a community of people that I can rely on no matter where I go in the world. I can be proud of who I am and who I love. Remember, we carry pride every day. We carry it in our hearts. Happy Pride, everyone.
Hi, everyone. I'm PC Jones.
And I'm T. Sketch.
And together we are Phenomenon. Thank you so much for having us. We are a duo out of New York City and also partners. And we are so happy to be here to celebrate New Jersey Pride.
Happy Pride, y'all.
We hope that you are at home feeling safe and happy, healthy, and that you're enjoying the show.
And also practicing self-care on this Sunday.
In light of recent events, we decided that we wanted to share a message with you. So yesterday we decided to write a new song. So today is the day that we are debuting it with you. I hope you like it.
It's called Our Pain.
You wanna know why? Chicago, 1919. Tulsa, 21. Watts, 65. Detroit, 67. Stonewall, 69. Miami, 80. LA, 92. The whole country in 2020.
And you ask why, then you
forever feel the pain. Trauma cycle is insane. Tears falling like the rain. No talk, we need change. Killing us at close range. Then look at us all strange. Saying we can't complain. Please stop the sick game. Whirlwind up in flames. Last stop on this train. For every blood stain, every ancestor slain, for every soul slain. We standing as a people. We done with the evil. No longer live in fear. We see right through you. Always try to sneak through. Seeking the gaslight. We bleeding for past lives. You infiltrated with lies. Cries fall from the skies. And from our beloved's eyes. We ripping off the disguise. Power tripping off pride. And when we try to ride, his guys hit the fight. Freedom is mummified. 400 years paralyzed. Terrified of the hip side. True history's inscribed. No longer we're letting hide.
Ask why, then you close your eyes. Can you hear it in our cries? We are fighting for our lives.
Thank you guys so much for having us today.
Thank you.
If you want to find more Phenom Risen, we're on phenomrisen.com, and I am on Casey Jones Music at every platform, also Phenom Risen on every platform.
I'm also T-Sketch Music on every platform, and we love being here with you guys today. Thank you for having us. Peace, love, and light to y'all.
Thank you guys so much. Also, if you guys want to know about the beat, this is the one who made it. You can find her on T-Sketch Beats anywhere as well. Peace, love, light. I love you guys. Be safe.
Stay safe and enjoy your Sunday. Peace, y'all.
Hi, I'm Congressman Frank Pallone. Normally you have the Pride Festival in Asbury Park, but I know we can't do that, so we're having this virtually. But I did want to say how important it is for Garden State Equality and its members to keep up the activism against discrimination. One of the things that I continue to work on in Congress is the Equality Act, because we have to avoid any kind of discrimination and make it illegal to discriminate against the LGBTQ community. So happy Pride, and hopefully we'll be together again next year to celebrate in person.
One night, I left my friends. They wondered where I went, and I wondered that too. It was supposed to be another night of being hypnotized by beautiful boys and their bodacious thighs while dancing all dumb, doubting danger, dosing drugs, and drinking with strangers. But for the first time in a long time, I had to stay home. I stayed home and roamed at a place where I could live lies and tell truths to which I could now confront and I could have control. So instead of collectively cheering with community, I had to come back to my closet. I had to come back to wonder why I wandered away. I came back to think. I thought about touch and what it means in my community to be told we're good enough with just our fingertips. I thought about drag queens demanding democracy, diluting drama, and giving the damned more damage. I thought about trans women as our lives are taken like ticks and talks. We take our time and we tell our truth. I thought about how bold our bodies were, bumping and booming to each other's beat in a bustling gay bar with sweat and heat. I feel baptized. I thought about our lovers who leave and live their lives, not promising a tomorrow or next times. I thought about our past pulling and pushing our people into poverty and how that is still our present. I thought about how lesbians living life loud and loving louder while gay men lusting in a crowd and liberating prouder just to give us each a bit of power. I thought about how black and brown really bond to know what is a rainbow. I thought about the first time that you and I met and we hosted a hug instead of a handshake because in our community, our hearts are humble homes together. I thought about my closets and our closets and how we keep our colorful clothes kept away with our courage until that one day you find yourself a key. Whether it's a book, a person, a song, an article, or a magazine, one thing is one day something set us free. Free from failure to perform perfectly. Because when they only saw these wounds of skin, honey, we were born to be burned in. It shows how every day I am still flaming, how my love, my sexuality, my gender, my pride is something I will always be claiming. The night I left my friends to make amends with an odds and ends, I call that just another weekend's cleanse. The first step was to place a mirror in my closet. The last step was to be honest. My name is Sylvia Thomas. I'm from Indianapolis, Indiana. I am a spoken word artist, and the piece you heard is something I wrote called Memory Closet. Feel free to follow me on all types of platforms. My at username for everything is she is Sylvia, S-Y-L-V-I-A. Feel free to reach out to me. I want to be there for you. I want to thank you, New Jersey Pride, for having me. New Jersey, yes! I know that it's hard right now having Pride alone at home, but you're... life continues to matter, especially our Black lives. I want to take time to recognize the Black Lives Matter movement and its intersectional voice it has had with our queer movement. It is necessary. It is important. We would not have Pride without Black life. Thank you to everyone that is joined here today. I can't wait to see what other performances are to come. Thank you again. Happy Pride, Diva.
What's going on, everybody? This is your boy, Lane McCrae from the Boosh. That's right, the one and the only, coming to you live from Germany. And right now, I want to introduce my partner, Sophie Cairo, who is down in Adelaide, Australia, a lot of hours away from me right now. And we all wish that we could be on stage performing for you guys real soon. So we don't know when that's going to be. But until then, I want you to enjoy this connect. All right, check it out.
You too.
it up on Sophie Cairo. I'm Leigh McRae, and we are live.
It's been said that timing is everything. Well, my timing isn't always great, because while I was asked to do a video about what JPI and Pride mean to me, I'm in my house recovering from COVID and pneumonia after more than 5 weeks in the hospital. So an open letter is pretty much the best I can do. My timing, however, was much better in 1993 when I joined the New Jersey Lesbian and Gay Coalition and volunteered for its Pride Parade Committee. In addition to becoming one of the founders of JPI the following year, I had the great good fortune of befriending Sherry and Laura and Karen and Linda, among so many others in the community who I hope will forgive me for not naming them all individually. For the past almost 30 years, these people have been a treasured part of my life, and we've been there for each other in times both terrific and awful. No greater benefit can come from human connections. I've been continuously volunteering for Pride each year because it gives me the chance to renew these connections, but even more so because it allows me to participate in something greater than the sum of us. Every year, I look at the 15,000 to 20,000 attendees, depending on weather, and wonder where in the world all these people are during the rest of the year. Some time ago, I realized that question was rhetorical, as the answer really doesn't matter. The important thing is that they're there, celebrating, marching, enjoying, out loud and proud. It's our day to enjoy, with entertainers, politicians, public officials, and other speakers welcoming us, speaking to us, and caring about us. Being a part of the organization that produces this event is incredibly rewarding, as I see attendees who weren't even born when we created JPI, to those I've seen many times before, to some even older than me. It's about creating a safe space, an environment where we can all be ourselves, even for one day, the way the world should be every day. This year, we can only be together in spirit, but I'm hopeful that next year, the timing will allow us all to celebrate in Asbury Park again.
First Pride was a riot, and Rocky Horror is my favorite weekly riot.
Pride to me means never having to fear to be who you are. And Rocky lets us be whoever we want to be. It's one big year-long Pride celebration.
Just a jump to the left.
Pride means to me is that love is love. Love whoever the f*** you want. Be proud of it. Don't let anybody change you or tell you otherwise. We are like the biggest, most accepting community ever. 100%. Like, we are everything in one with Rocky. Like, everything in one whole package.
Pride to me means being unafraid to be yourself and being able to show your true colors. And it's a place where everyone can come together and really be themselves once a year at least. And to me, Rocky Horror and the Rocky Horror community was where I came out for the first time. So I never felt really comfortable being myself until...
Let's do the time warp again.
on your hip.
We'll see you in October.
I'm freaking out. Ooh, I'm gonna flip this car.
You cannot flip this car.
I'm gonna flip this goddamn car.
You can't flip a car.
Hey guys, I'm Sam.
Hey guys, I'm Erica, and this is what Pride means to us.
Pride to us is being who you are, never hiding behind anyone's shadows, and leaving a rainbow on everyone's doorstep.
Make sure you always speak your truth, and never let anyone stand in your way. Take pride in what you say. The videos that we showed were from Pride last June. To be able to march and hold hands with the person you love, it was a complete honor. That's what Pride means to us.
Hey guys, I'm back again. Thank you. And thank you. What a great, great afternoon. Thank you all for being here. This next song, without a doubt, it will be forever attached to my back pocket and my hip and my butt. And so I think that you know what this song is. And 3 months ago, this song was inducted into the Library of Congress. So for that honor, of course, it gives me nothing but pleasure from the bottom of my heart to perform this song for you, and I think you guys know what it is, all right? Yes, why? We're gonna spell it. Get up from the couch, okay? So it's Y-M-C, no, you're over left, C-A, put it all together, and what do you have? Y-M-C-A! Young man, there's no need to feel down. I said, young man, pick yourself off the ground. I said, young man, 'cause you're in a new town. There's no need to be unhappy. Young man, there's a place you can go. I said, young man, when you're short on your dough, you can stay there. And I'm sure you will find many ways to have a good time. It's fun to stay at the YMCA. It's fun to stay at the YMCA. They have everything for your mental enjoy. You can hang out with all the boys. YMCA. It's fun to stay at the YMCA. You can get yourself clean. You can have a good meal. You can do whatever you I was once in your shoes, I said I was down and out with the blues. I felt no man cared if I was alive. I felt the whole world was so jacked. That's when someone came up to me and said, young man, take a walk up the street. There's a place there called the YMCA. They can start you back on your way. It's fun to stay at the YMCA. It's fun to stay at the YMCA. They have everything for your men to enjoy. You can hang out with all the boys. YMCA. It's fun to stay at the YMCA. Young man, there's no need to feel down. Young man, pick yourself off the ground. YMCA. Thank you.
Hey, Jersey Pride, it's Lauren Albrecht, representing the New Jersey Democratic State Committee's LGBTQ caucus. We wanted to send you a quick video
First, to thank you for all the work that you do year after year to bring us all together, and we can't wait to see you again in person next year. We also wanted to let you know that we're still out here working very hard to get LGBTQ candidates elected to office all over the state of New Jersey, to remind everybody that it's important to support LGBTQ candidates when they run for office, and to run for office if you're an LGBTQ candidate. Right now, more than ever, visibility and representation are critical aspects of making the change that we need to see in this country. So we hope to see you at the polls.
And now, please join us for a moment of silence to give voice through silence to all those we have lost to AIDS. Let us also remember all those we have lost due to the hatred against the LGBTQ community, especially trans women of color, who experience some of the highest rates of violence. Together, let's honor them all. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Lori Michaels, and I'm proud to be part of Jersey Pride with all our friends and families. This is my song called Standing Here, dedicated to anyone who's ever lost someone you love.
When you wake up in the morning and you start your day the same, you never think a moment would make your whole world change. When you kiss your wife goodbye, just don't realize that this time was the last time that you'd feel the tender touch. You would look deep in her eyes. Oh God, my God, why? It can't be gone.
Celestina. I'm an Asbury Park and New Jersey based drag queen known as the top hatted Broadway diva of New Jersey. Yes, get into it. I had the privilege of performing at Jersey Pride last year, 2019, and I'm so excited that they asked me to be part of this virtual event that they're putting on. Jersey Pride has always been so important to me, and so I'm so glad to be part of this. Jersey Pride has brought so many incredible people together. It is what helped so many people release themselves. They're allowed to just be who they are and celebrate who they are, and it's so great to share time with so many incredible people who are just being so incredibly, authentically, unapologetically themselves. And so I'm so glad to be sharing this moment with you. And with everything else going on, who doesn't want a little joy in their life? And so this is for all of you, and I hope you enjoy.
Is a hopeless jumble, and the raindrops tumble all around. Heaven opens a magic lane when all the clouds darken up the skyway. There's a rainbow highway to be found.
Hello, everyone. This is Stephen Blazejewski from the New Jersey LGBT Chamber of Commerce. We at the Chamber have a commitment to celebrating diversity in all of its forms, especially within the LGBT community. I would like to thank Jersey Pride and Garden State Equality for putting this amazing event together. And from all of us at the NJ LGBT Chamber, happy Pride.
Hi, everyone. My name is Mackenzie Murray, and I'm a representative of Gala Wine Sales of New Jersey. And on behalf of everyone at Gala Wine Sales, we want to wish our Asbury community a happy Pride Month.
Hello, it's Pete Buttigieg in South Bend with warm greetings to Garden State Equality and everyone celebrating Pride this month. Of course, Pride 2020 comes in an unprecedented moment, one that calls us to see how we all fit in a larger story. The pandemic that brought America to a standstill calls forth memories of a different confrontation with the deadly virus that ravaged generations of gay Americans, a story that has much to teach us in this moment. And in the national anguish over systemic racism and the killing of George Floyd and so many others, we are called to ask what each of us is doing in the struggle for racial justice. This is a time to reflect on allyship, and a time to honor the leadership of queer Black voices in our country and movement all the way back to Pride as we know it, beginning in a moment of police violence more than 50 years ago. Every struggle is different, but every struggle is connected. And Pride marks not just a celebration, but a recognition of struggle. Best wishes to everyone participating in that celebration and that struggle in so many ways this June and in the months and years to come.
Hey, Jersey Pride, J-Line here. Even though we can't be together this year physically, we can be together virtually celebrating who we are, how far we've come, and most of all that whatever happens, we are gonna get through it together. So I hope you guys have a great Pride. I hope you continue to believe in yourselves. And I hope you enjoy this song. We just turned off all the lights in my apartment. And I just thought, if you can't go to the club, I'm gonna bring the club to you. So we filmed this whole thing in my apartment. I hope you enjoy it. Happy Pride.
Ha! Something in the air tonight. I know I can make this right. I'ma set my body free. Let's go! Woo! Sick of playing by the rules. I'ma do what I wanna do. And I'm gonna do it with you.
I'm a 13-year-old transgender youth activist from New Jersey. To me, Pride is not just about celebrating my identity, but also honoring the people who got us here. I can only live the life I do because of the queer and trans people of color who put their lives on the line before me. The thing is, those lives are still on the line. They always have been. Black LGBTQ plus folks have carried this burden for far too long, fighting for the LGBTQ plus community and fighting against white supremacy and the racism that has always been there. I went to my first protest way before I went to my first Pride Festival. And I think that's how it always should be. That's how Pride started. This year, Pride must look like showing up loudly and proudly for our siblings of color. In the streets, in our communities, with our elected officials, and with our doctors.
Hi everyone, my name is Bianca. I'm the Health and Wellness Coordinator of Garden State Equality. This is the Elders for Equality group, and we wanted to tell you Happy Pride.
Happy Pride Month. 2020, Happy Pride.
Happy Pride.
Hello there, New Jersey Pride 2020. This is the Dorothy Zbornak from the Golden Gays NYC reporting to you live from here, which is, by the way, down the shore, as your people are wont to say, but I am quarantined inside this screened-off room. But anyway, I digest.
What does pride mean to me? Let that freak flag fly. Show all of your colors of the rainbow, sugar. Be fierce. Be confident. Be sexy. Because guess what? There's only one you. Might as well own it. And as RuPaul says, if they ain't paying your bills, pay them bitches no minds.
What pride means to me is honoring those who paved the way before us. Who helped us get to where we are today, which is out and loud and proud. It also means to unapologetically be yourself. Dress the way you want, be who you want, love who you want.
It means a day that I can be my true, authentic self and be accepted for that. It means marching in the street as my true, authentic self, whether she's in, you know, a fur hat or not, and being accepted by those around me. It means taking your very cute shoes and putting them in to your handbag and carrying them and using your ugly, practical shoes to walk around in, because you're going to be on your feet. It's a march, after all. Pride is Stonewall. It's a riot, it's a march, it's a parade, it's freedom to be.
We do hope that you enjoy this little sneak peek from our musical extravaganza, The Golden Games, a Pride musical game show, in which we start the show with that rousing number from La Cage aux Folles.
In the words of the great Jerry Herman,
we are what we are. Please enjoy, and remember, stay golden.
Listen, if you can't be yourself, be Arthur. Happy Pride.
We are what we are, and what we are is an illusion. We love how it feels, putting on heels, causing confusion.
Thank you.
Hello, everyone, and happy Pride Month. My name is Wayne Boatwright, and I am Vice President of Diversity and Inclusion. Clearly, our care for our LGBTQ community is critical. We have developed a team member resources group called Pride and Allies. The other thing is that we're very, very excited to be recognized by the Health Equality Index, HEI, for our treatment of our team members and our LGBTQ community. We also spend a lot of times with our national and local organizations in making sure that we're creating best practices in trying to care for this population.
We have developed policy and procedure, and we are so happy to be involved and create environments that are safe and inclusive for not only our patients that we serve, but our team members who work for the organization. It is an honor to be a part of this celebration this month. Thank you so very much.
Happy Jersey Pride Virtually 2020. My name is Bob. I am with the AIDS Memorial Quilt New Jersey chapter. We are here to say Happy Pride. We are here to thank Jersey Pride for their continued support over the last almost 30 years. As we have come from the AIDS pandemic, we are an opportunity to remember, those from our community that we have lost. We are here to educate, and we are here to celebrate, the lives of those who were lost to the AIDS pandemic, and we are here to celebrate Pride, and we are here to be grateful for the continued support of our community to our organization. So unfortunately, we are not physically in Asbury this year, but we are virtually available on our website, www.namesnnj.org, for where one can go and see the quilt virtually for 2020. And we look forward to seeing everyone in Asbury for Pride 2021. Thank you. Happy Pride.
Hi, I'm Chief Investigator Dave D'Amico. Happy Pride from Middlesex County Department of Corrections and Youth Services.
Hi, I'm Lieutenant John Hayes.
I'm Sergeant Amber Hart.
Happy Pride!
Happy Pride Month from the Union County Sheriff's Office.
Hello, I'm Senior Parole Officer Brenda Payne of the New Jersey Division of Parole.
This is Patrolman Caitlin Dean from the Highland Park Police Department. I'm just dropping in to wish everybody a happy and safe Pride.
Hi, my name is Officer Brooks from Union County Sheriff's Office. Happy Pride Month. Stay safe, everyone.
Hey, everybody. I'm Lieutenant Heather Bologlich from the Morris Township Police Department. And on behalf of our entire agency, Happy Pride Month.
Hi, I'm Officer Johnson with the Morristown Bureau of Police. Happy Pride, everyone.
I'm Lieutenant David Russo with New Jersey State Parole. Happy Pride Month.
Happy Pride Month from the Cape May County Prosecutor's Office. Stay healthy and safe, everybody.
Hi, this is Officer Anthony Perez with the Morris County Sheriff's Office. Just wanted to wish you all a happy Pride.
Hey everybody, this is Josh Zuckerman, and happy Pride everybody. I am so honored to be able to perform a song for you guys virtually here from my renovated music room here. And Asbury Park is my home away from home, so again, it's such an honor and I love to be with you all. So I'm going to be performing one of my brand new singles called My Hallelujah, and the music video is going to be playing on in the background. And the song My Hallelujah is off of my brand new CD called Gone With The Music, and you can check it out on the web. JoshZuckerman.com, as well as, you know, of course, these awesome summer Pride shirts here. are for sale as well. I have to do a little plug. Doesn't matter. Black, white, gay, straight, rich, poor, thin, fat. Doesn't matter. And on the back, it just says, I just want to be me. It's all about being true to yourself and loving yourself. Anyway, so I'm going to be singing you guys my brand new song, My Hallelujah. Here we go.
This is Senator Vin Gopal wishing you a very happy Pride to each and every one of you. While I'm disappointed that we won't be celebrating together, I know we're celebrating virtually, as Pride Month is so important. One of my favorite times of the year is marching in the Pride Parade in Asbury Park, where together tens of thousands of people are united through race, religion, sex, sexual orientation, and everything that unites us in one common theme, humanity. And we need to remember that now, as this crisis goes across the country, not just COVID-19, but the crisis of race relations and our police departments. So let's stand together. Let's lift all vulnerable populations up and make sure we fight for equality. I want to thank Christian Fuscarino and the entire Garden State Equality Board for all that they do each and every day to make sure that we have equality across the board. God bless each of you. Stay safe, and I know we're going to be together in person very soon. Happy Pride.
To me, Pride is a space where people can get together, be themselves, celebrate the diversity of the community, and raise awareness and have fun. Happy Pride.
What's happening, everybody? My name is Tyler, and I want to say first and foremost, thank you so much for allowing me to be a part of this awesome event. It's truly an honor. And with that, I want to share with you my latest single titled Bad News. Here we go.
You call after I'm gone and we say our goodbyes. You call endurance way too long. You text me when it's clear that I'm being polite. Found a thousand ways to tell you no. And it's true, ooh, ooh. The next message I sent, it's no reply. But still you, ooh, ooh, keep my inbox the farthest thing from dry. You keep hitting me up, baby, but I've got some bad, bad news. I've got some bad, bad news. Hey, I've got some bad, bad. I've got some bad, bad news. Some bad, bad news. I've got some bad, bad news. Yeah. It's too late for you to come back and ruin my life. Poor taste for you to try so long. You hate when I admit that I'm doing alright, but you love to tell me how you've grown. And it's true, ooh, ooh. The next message I sent needs no reply. But still you, ooh, ooh, keep my inbox the farthest thing from dry. You keep hitting me up, baby, but I've got some bad, bad news. News, you keep hitting me up, baby. I've got some bad, bad news. I've got some bad, bad. I've got some bad, bad news. Some bad, bad news. I've got some bad, bad news. I've got some bad, bad news, news. You keep me falling in love, baby. Ain't that some bad, bad news? I've got some bad, bad. I've got some bad, bad news. Some bad, bad news. I've got some bad, bad news.
Thank you, guys. And please, enjoy the rest of your day. Bye.
Happy Pride, everybody. It's Amy Quinn, Deputy Mayor in Asbury Park. And what makes Pride Pride to me is the ability for this amazing festival to allow the LGBTQ community in a safe space, in a safe place, and catching up with old friends, meeting new friends, and also making sure that we're galvanized for the next fight in the LGBTQ community. You know, it's a festival that not only is a hell of a lot of fun, but it also gets you up to speed on what's coming down the pike politically and how you can get involved and make sure that the LGBTQ rights are protected. My most memorable Asbury Park Pride event, I have a few. I joke all the time. I have repeatedly lost my phone in the Wonder Bar bathroom, drunk, during Asbury Pride. This year I won't because it's virtual. Well, let's hope I don't. And my most memorable event was I was standing in line with my wife. Sophie B. Hawkins had performed and was signing CDs. And she had this big lesbian anthem, Damn Wish I Was Your Lover. And so I stand on line and Heather stands, you know, a little bit away. And I get up to her, I go to get the CD, and I completely and utterly freeze and quite literally run away. Heather comes in, has her sign the CD, and then we walk away. So that was probably my most memorable Pride. I don't remember what year. But we are so sorry to be missing the 29th Asbury Park Pride in June. We're hopefully going to come back in October. And if we don't come back in October, we're certainly going to do some virtual stuff in June. So happy Pride, everybody. Get your assless chaps out. Let's do this.
Hey, everyone. We are Sister Funk. We're so excited to be here to celebrate United in Pride with you. We're going to do a brand new song. It's called This American Life.
Beautiful for spacious skies, for amber waves of
Thank you, everybody. Happy Pride. Sister Funk signing out from Connecticut.
Hello, I'm Sue Doster with Jersey Pride. I'm one of the many volunteers who work year-round to bring you this Pride event. Although this year is a little different from past years, Pride still manages to find a way. Whether it's driving rain and people still show up to march, or a situation where we're all sheltered in place and we all come together online to connect. Over the years, Pride has served many purposes. It's been, it's provided the ability to protest. It's provided the ability to be visible, to connect as a community. It, of course, has been a celebration. And it is very necessary given our current climate, these days and times. With our current void of national leadership, the situation calls on all of us to become leaders in our own way. And I have been honored to serve alongside my fellow volunteers at Jersey Pride to continue to support our community. Jersey Pride made a number of donations to local and national organizations supporting communities and groups negatively affected by the COVID-19 pandemic. I am proud to be part of Jersey Pride. And whether you are a festival attendee, whether you are someone who marches in the parade, whether you're a volunteer who works to put on the events, or someone who's just discovering us online, you are part of Jersey Pride. And together, we are stronger. We need to use our voices to speak for those who cannot speak for themselves. We need to embrace compassion during these turbulent times. We need to be there for each other because community and connection is the way we're all going to get through this. So I'm proud to be part of Jersey Pride. I'm proud to know all of you. And remember, Jersey Pride is Jersey Strong. Happy Pride, everybody.
Hello, everyone. My name is Edward Vasquez, and I'm going to dedicate to you the song I wrote called Semilla de Fe, Seeds of Faith. And I'd like to also wish everyone a happy New Jersey Virtual Pride Parade. Levántate, abre tus ojos, mira hacia arriba, hacia los cielos, no tengas miedo, vente conmigo, vamos a brigarnos contra este frío, atrévete conmigo. Que cosas buenas pasan también, mil maravillas van a crecer de una semilla sembrada de fe. No cuesta nada creer en sueños, juntos podemos abrazar el cielo. Esperanza, ilusión, unidos somos la solución contra la corriente en toda tormenta. Aguanta mi mano, estaré a tu lado. Vente conmigo, no
tengas miedo. Eternamente estaré contigo. Atrévete conmigo a creer que cosas buenas pasan también. Mil maravillas van a crecer de una semilla sembrada de fe.
Hey, Asbury.
I'm Ben.
And I'm Nick.
And our company is called Outer Peace Gear, and that brings us into what Pride means to us.
So we derived the name Outer Peace Gear, actually, from what Pride means to us. I think as a person who was raised by a lesbian mom and her partner, and who came out as a lesbian myself when I was 18, and then coming out as a trans man at 30, I was always longing for the ability to just be my authentic self. I always felt stifled, like I couldn't dress how I wanted to dress, I couldn't wear my hair how I wanted to wear my hair. It would be unacceptable for me to transition, people wouldn't accept me, people wouldn't love me anymore. So I feel like my entire life I was searching for outer peace. And Ben had a similar experience, right?
Yeah, I actually grew up mainly in the straight community until I was about 27, 28 when I started to realize something was way off about me. And it took me a lot of YouTube video watching and soul searching to realize that I was trans and that that's what I was experiencing pretty much my whole life. And so once I discovered that and I started going to the local trans groups, I started to become more comfortable with myself and realized that I want to transition. And immediately, right after discovering all this about myself, I started doing the Pride events with Nick and discovered that that was definitely just the place where I felt the most comfortable, being surrounded by my community and the people who understood me and didn't judge me.
And Asbury was actually one of the first Pride festivals that we did together.
When we
met, we were still presenting female, and we went through all of our transition together. Everything from getting letters from doctors and surgeries and dysphoria and just emotional support coming out to family and friends. It was amazing to have somebody who knew exactly what we were feeling.
We're pretty lucky in that way.
Yeah. So now we have the outer peace that we've always been searching for. We are so gonna miss seeing everybody's face this year at the festivals. It's like truly what we live for, is just seeing people in person and getting to connect with the community in that way. But we do hope that everybody is safe and healthy and stays that way.
We'll miss you this year, but we really hope that we all get to be together again next year.
Yeah.
So to sum it all up, to us, Pride means being with community.
Being visible.
Being authentic.
And living your truth.
Hey y'all, Deputy Diamond here, all the way from Martinsburg, West Virginia, to celebrate Jersey Pride, especially the ones down in Asbury Park. All right, well, we're here to celebrate love is love is love, always love during these crazy times. So I'm just gonna do a little song for you guys, and I hope you guys like it.
Corolla for miles in front of me. I don't need your help and I don't need sympathy. I don't need you to lower the bar for me. I know I'm superwoman.
pretend the witch is fine. The only way to live now is to know you're gonna fly. To listen to the lies and the lies. I know I'm super warm, I know I'm strong. I know I've got this case, I've had it all along.
With the African American Office of Gay Concerns. Now, when I think about pride, I don't necessarily think about community pride per se. I think about, you know, growing up in Dallas, Texas, way back in the 60s and the 70s, and my parents having to explain to us how proud we needed to be because we were black people, and the fact that we went to the Catholic school, the white school, you know, we had to be, you know, doubly proud of who we are and hold our heads up high. And when I was, a late teenager and I was coming out to my mom, I remember we were sitting at a Woolworths counter having a banana split of all things. And I asked her, you know, what do you think? And she was like, well, first of all, she wasn't surprised because, you know, mothers know, they always know. But when I asked her if she was proud of the way I turned out, she said, of course I am. I would be proud of you no matter what you did. But you've got to be proud of yourself. And you got to know that there's going to be some pain and some heartache and some trouble and people who hate you out there. But just remain true to yourself and you'll be okay. So pride to me means pride in myself, pride in my heritage, pride in being an openly black gay man and living with that. I'm proud of my husband, 30 years, and I'm just glad to be around still. So bottom line for me is, you know, be proud of yourself, be true to yourself, because you can't be proud of a community if you're not proud of yourself. So I'll just say happy Pride Month, happy Pride Day, happy Pride everything. Just say stay safe and be well. I'll talk to you later.
Hi, Jack. How are you today?
Good.
Good. Would you like to hear a book about a parade?
Me, Bobby,
yes. Yes? Okay. This is a book called This Day in June, and it's about a pride parade. So you can look for the rainbows as I read it to you, okay?
Okay. I found all the rainbows on the front.
You see all the rainbows on the front? Good. Then I'll turn the page and we'll go inside. And I'll turn one page at a time, and here we go. This Day in June. And this is written by Gail Pittman, and it's illustrated by Christina Litton. And the illustrations are really beautiful. This day in June, parade starts soon.
Rainbow, 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 rainbow.
Good. Rainbow arches, joyful march.
Rainbow, rainbow.
Lots of rainbows.
Rainbow.
This is how the parade starts.
Rainbow.
Boaters roaring.
Rainbow.
Spirits soaring. Motorcycles?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Voices
chanting. Rainbow, rainbow, rainbow,
rainbow.
Rainbow. Rainbow.
Clay
rainbow.
Leather. Perfect weather.
Rainbow.
Lots of rainbows. Artists painting. Sisters sainting. Banners swaying, children playing.
Rainbow, rainbow.
Dancers jumping, music pumping.
Hey, Mama, Didi?
Yes?
Go this way because I saw a rainbow.
You saw a rainbow on this page?
Yes. No, no, on this. On this page.
Here it is. Here's the rainbow flag. Is
that
the one you're
rainbow talking about? Rainbow. No. It was... I think I didn't.
We'll get to it. Where is it?
I think I didn't see one.
Okay. Let's keep turning. Sidewalk shaking. Tummies aching.
Rainbow.
Painted ladies.
Rainbow.
Crying babies. Did you know that the painted ladies were really these houses back here? They were all different colors and they're called the painted ladies.
Rainbow.
Fancy dresses. Flowing dresses.
Rainbow.
Dresses means hair.
Rainbow.
Loving
rainbow
kisses.
Won't
so delicious. All invited, all excited. This day in June, we're all united. Happy Pride, Jack. Happy Pride, everyone.
Hey, everybody. The Green Planet here. Everyone should be proud of who they are, and Jersey Pride is a time to get together with your friends and family, celebrate, and share the love. We are, and we hope you are, too.
Good evening, Happy Pride. My name is Jason Scott. I'm the founding executive director of our institute, the Pride Institute of Southern New Jersey. As we reflect and celebrate Pride through our homes, apartments, and safe spaces, unfortunately, with loved ones near and far, but let's not lose sight of the accomplishments as New Jerseyans, as community members and leaders and activists that we have done over the years that fell up to this day. And I am so proud to be part of a state that humbly opens their minds and sets their goals and values to ensuring that people like me are safe and welcomed in all walks of life. But unfortunately, for many places in New Jersey and outside New Jersey, it is still to Pride to me as well. It is still a riot. It is still a riot to POCs, people of color, every day for being attacked and accused and harassed for being their own skin. And not only that, being murdered by police brutality as well, through our media and being and screaming their own stories and voices that it took today, the last few days, to hear their cries, our cries, to be equal. It is still a riot for transgender individuals. Still a riot. They are the pillar of our community and we can never stop making them. But unfortunately, they are getting harassed, murdered, and executed, and arrested, and lynched. Lynched. For being who they are. And fighting and not being, and with confidence and class and grace. Unfortunately, we have to give them roses long after they're gone. Thank you. And happy Pride.
What's up, guys? My name is One Time Freestyle from the New York Red Bulls Freestyle Crew, and I want to thank the New Jersey Pride and Garden State Equality for having us part of this special celebration. We'll always enjoy being part of the New Jersey Pride Parade and festivals, and we are very happy to celebrate it with you all at our homes. Challenge you to celebrate by trying the rainbow trick. Check it out. Thank you for having us, and we can't wait to see you guys at the next parade. Let's go. We'll be right back.
life is a riddle, but it always seems they meet somewhere in the middle. Our similarities, and we will face much adversity, so we must find strength in our diversity.
My name is Dustin Hausner, and I just wanted to wish you a happy, peaceful, beautiful, joyful, mindful Pride Month. However you choose to celebrate, I hope you enjoy yourself. I hope you take this month to reach out to other members of the beautiful LGBTQIA+ communities, to learn, to talk, to share love, compassion, empathy, and to be there for one another. I hope you have a wonderful time. Stay safe, stay healthy. And happy Pride Month.
Happy Pride. Portia here, and I just wanted to say I wish I could be with you. Unfortunately, this year that's just not possible for any of us. But remember, Pride is Pride. It's a day to celebrate love, joy, equality, and most importantly, love. Love one another. Love the people next door to you. Love the people around the block from you. And honestly, if one person gives you hell about blasting Lady Gaga all day, that's on them. Today is your day. Love it, enjoy it, and happy Pride. So, they asked me to do a few of the classic ladies for you, so I figured, why not? Let's gay it up a little. No, it's not Cardi B. Focus. Marilyn Monroe. The thing of that. Die for love. It's Friday. Thank you. but I prefer a man who lives and gives expensive jewels. A kiss on the hand may be quite caught in that look. Diamonds are a girl's best friend. A kiss may be grand, but it won't pay the bill on your umbrella or help you at the automatic. Then go call up on the girls go, and we all lose a chance in the end. But square cut or pear shape, these locks are the loose. Pear shape, diamonds are the girl's best friend.
That was some show. Thank you, Portia, Queen of Key West and Girl of a Thousand Voices. Thank you, friends at home and all the ships at sea, for joining us for Jersey Pride's first ever virtual Pride. Jersey Pride thanks all of our performers, speakers, technicians, and everyone responsible for creating celebration from silence. We appreciate the strength of our partnership with Garden State Equality, and we look forward to seeing all of you in Asbury Park, October 11th. Stay safe, stay healthy, and show everyone your love.
Everyone, this is Elizabeth. As you can see, it's the day before Pride, and we are just getting the banner started. This is what it should look like when I'm done. Let's see what happens.